I've made a lot of videos on controller modifications. I showed you how to beef up the traces, change the fets, overvolt, undervolt. This one's a virgin, basically. This is a $30 eBay controller, and I haven't even had a look inside of it myself. So we're going to open it up, and I'm going to do all the things that I've done to my past ones, but I won't show you that. But what I will show you is in this video is how to do a simple thing, like you don't have to overvolt it if you want a little bit more torque. I'll show you how to adjust the shunt simply by pinching them together and a little bit of solder. So we'll go ahead and do that. I'll show you how to do it properly so you don't end up blowing your controller up, because if you overdo it, you'll blow it up. Well, there's the inside of it. This one is 35 amps max at 48 volts, 1000 watt. So there's the shunt, that's what it looks like. This model has three, most of them have two or one, the lower end ones. I've been pumping over 60 volts in this sucker, it doesn't even get warm. And the caps look like they've survived, surprisingly. You don't like how those fets are mounted there. See, they're all sideways and looking like they're ready to touch each other. Eesh. Sloppy. But other than that, it's been a good controller for what I paid for it. It's unmodded. It's pretty much a virgin. So what we're going to do is just basically we're going to just take two of the shunts, squeeze them together a little bit, and then butter it up a little bit with some solder on the end. That should bring us up to about 40. And I gotta also check the fets to see what the maximum amp draw on them is. Well, that would explain why I couldn't damage this controller. It's the model of the chip is a P75NF75. It's rated for 75 volts at 80 amps continuous. So I think I'm all right by lathering up this a little bit. And I stick to my same voltage. Maybe I'll change the caps, the 60 volt caps, that's about it, these two here. But I think I got my money's worth on this. This controller cost me 30 bucks shipped, so I got a good deal. And there's my butter job. We can set to change the caps, and we're good to go. Got to do those two there, and the two small ones, which I'm sure I have. And then we'll call it a day on this one. There we go, we're done. Caps are done. The shunt is done. This won't speed the bike, well, I mean, it might speed the bike up a bit, but what it will do is it'll give it a little bit of a oof when you hit the throttle if you're crossing the street. Without just buttering the end up, gives it a couple of more amps. So, there you go.